Emma will be a good evening, Yama, good afternoon, Yama, good evening. Baby, I will be a senior umbreno at ye, Onyankupon, a shrow, and then you may, it is a marriage survivor. What does the Bible says about the Christian or about Christian's marriage? That is Christian dating and courtship. By Reverend Betty Timothy Prempeh here. Hope of Glory Network TV on Facebook, Hope of Glory Network Radio. You can get us on Ghana Web and Hope of Glory Network Prayer Line. God richly bless you here. So Reverend Betty Timothy Prempeh is ready here to talk to us about Christian dating and Christian marriage. Don't go away. She is coming soon. She's already here. God richly bless you. Your DJ this evening is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Trenkansa from Maryland, United States. God richly bless you. Missy Mo. If you are moving or going with a young woman, a young man, and you intend to marry the person, what do you need to know? What do you need to understand? What are the do's and what are the don'ts? That is what we're going to talk about here on Hope of Glory Network Radio. God richly bless you. Hallelujah. It's time now to welcome Reverend Evangelist Betty Timothy Prempeh. Reverend, good evening, good afternoon.
Good evening, Papa Onyami Eshaw.
May God richly bless you. May God richly bless you. Today is a Friday. It's a great day that the Lord has made. We will be glad and worship Him because He has done so much. Thanks for tuning in at my at Hope of Glory radio station. Onyami Ensha Ubebwe na Onya Wokesia. Then I watch you now for the whole of this week from Wednesday till now. We've been together from listening what God has for us. God richly bless you. God richly bless you for tuning in. Continue to invite your friends. Share the program on Facebook. Continue to call your siblings, call your fathers, call your mothers, whoever that you want them to be blessed. Kindly call them and they will be surely be blessed. God richly bless you. God richly bless you. Let me pray. Let me pray before we start the program. Any
Ebenezer, and I make a witty woman of the true near. Our survivors to Matina and true swing. Holy Spirit, lead us, guide us, and by the time that we stand, we will say, Father, thank you. Father, thank you. We bring this radio station in the blood of Jesus. May your blood cover it. May your blood protect it. Father, protect everybody that is about to come on the radio station. May you lead us. May you guide us. May you guide our mouth, whatever that we want to say. Father, let it come true in the name of Jesus. We thank you. We thank you in the name of the Son, the Father, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Amen. I survive a Jimmy Jane and Edward Street. So, my friend, when you be, invite your friends. Now, I'm so Emra Maye, Isha, I'm so Mamaye, Isha. Take a young guy anymore. Now, what you see me from Ukwada, Nami Hong Kong, Eddie Yay, Eddie Yako, the Yako baby, my topic in the bed, the Yako Yano, and your mumma Yan Shay. What's the Empire? So, what does the Bible say about Christian dating and courting? What does the Bible say? And then, I know who knows as far about dating. So, I'm going to share who can be, I'm going to share Baba will be, I'm going to share a brand will be. Now, as I want to teach you from Akra, not that she only in the area day, etna, and then, no, 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 aha is yada patrine as a yesu ama not a yane pa. We will continue part four next week if God willing. If God willing, when I mean, shall we pray? When I mean, shall we pray? May I ask someone? No, may I ask someone? If we and no, yes, now what she from Ukwada and Yawadano, our Bible verse that we use. Well, 2 Timothy 2 verse 22. But today we are directing to 1 Thessalonians 4 verse 3 to 5. Verse 3 to 5. Let's hear the word of God, what he has for us concerning hearing purity and purify ourselves when it comes to dating and courtship. It is very, very important as a Christian when we are waiting for the Lord, when we are waiting to say I do, what we have to do and what we don't have to do. Remain blessed and stay tuned, and God is with you. So I read 1 Thessalonians 4 verse 3. It is God's will that you should be sanctified, that you should avoid sexual immorality. I am not continuing. I am just saying it there because that is enough. That is enough for us to understand what God wants us to do and what He doesn't want us to do. Na eshe onyami te kukone eni mwenyam. Asi na ye onyami pe, so ye beti ye ho, ye beti ye ho. Na ye free, ye free, ye free, e jamai ho, ye free e jamai mu, ye free akono ho. E san se, hai mwa, ye shia no, a ye ye dey, ye eshe ye ho ni ye ho no. Why we are learning each other no? Why we are assessing each other, no? It's our responsibility as a Christian to remain holy till the day that the ring go on your hands. That is what God is looking for me and you to do. So we are coming to see how we can help, how we can do, how we can remain faithful in times like this. It is not easy. It is not easy. But remember, you have waited so patiently for all this, yes, for all this, yes. So for just 6 months or 1 year, you have to wait to glorify the name of the Lord. And this week, from Wednesday, Thursday, there was a lot of stuff that by God grace, we were able to share with you. We were able to share with you so many things, so many points. And today, we are going to continue as I have learned the Bible verse on the floor for us to understand where we are coming from and where we are going, which is 1 Thessalonians 4, 3 to 5. But I just wanted to remain the way. As time goes on, we will see what God wants for us on verse 4 and 5. Jamaican United States, the way, the Maya Korean, you know, the best idea when you want my our verse 4 and the verse 5. So I brand here, I was this war, Ababa was this war. Now we see what Yami fear, now we see what Yami Atom was saying. When you make a shame, sir, and when you make a chair was there, and was say a sinner of Rabo Kunkum, and was the Abramono, and such a new Christian, and sons our fear, and Yadia and Elia, they will move. When it comes to marriage, God is always, because God has defined marriage as what? As a blessing. So if it's time for you to marry, it's time you have to wait. You have to wait upon the Lord. You have to continue to pray. You have to wait to hear the voice of the Lord for God to be able to tell you that it's okay for you to go. It's not okay for you to go. It is very important. But most of us, we don't have patience. And we always think that, oh, this man, he is handsome. Oh, this woman, she exists. But this is very important. We shouldn't use passion or lust to do anything. But rather, we should use the word of God. We should have patience. And God will richly bless us. So we are coming to put a number for anyone who wants to call for contribution.
Amen. God richly bless you, Reverend. Very mercy. So, Adam, you know, I see. This is Hope of Glory Network Radio. You can get us from Ghana Web and Hope of Glory Network TV on Facebook. God richly bless you. The number to call us live, you can call live here to the studio. Dial +1 712 770 4700 and then access code is 413-699-pound. The number to dial live to get into the program to get your contribution in is +1 712 770 4700 Then you dial access code is 413-699 and pound. And then you can also text WhatsApp. Text WhatsApp is +1 347 559 9329 347 559 9329 So text to WhatsApp, or you can just dial this number on your phone direct to listen on the radio station live, and that will be +1 712 832 8113 8112. That is listening on the radio station direct. God richly bless you all. You can also text your question, comments, and contribution on Facebook page column. And I'm going to read it here live for you. I just want to say thank you to all of you, all the listeners on Facebook. We cherish you so much. Keep on listening and call your friends, your brothers and sisters to come and listen. How to date and courtship. As Christians, what does the Bible say? What is your man telling you? What is your woman telling you? Yesterday I said the same word that God used to bless us in the book of John chapter 3:16 that says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. And whosoever that believeth on him should not perish but have eternal life." So God came to this world with love. The same word is what Satan is using to deceive young beautiful women and young handsome guys out there. The same word, love. What do they do? "I love you, I love you." Not knowing he's trying to get what he wants to get from you. Just because the guy wants to remove your point. That is why he's telling you, "I love you." Just because that young woman, that lady, he wants to get the money from you. He wants to get what he wants to get out of you. So he wants to tell you, "I love you," in order for you to be swallow-headed. "Oh, Jed, Charlie, that guy loves me. You see, this is what we are deceiving yourself with. So it's better to learn how to date a woman, how to go with a woman before you marry her. Brother, God richly bless you. You can continue.
As we are talking about, it is very, very important. As 1 Thessalonians 4:3-5 saying, I am going to read the 4 for us to know what God has for us. Because at the end of the day, breaking marriages and the foundation wasn't from the Lord. And if we cannot build the foundation from the Lord, dating and the courting foundation is cut from right from the Christ, that immediately you saw the man, immediately you saw the woman, that God approved that, it's good for both of you to move together. That's where the foundation begins. But if we are not careful, we will break the rules here. Because out of lust, out of passion, that is the issue that is started leading us as a Christian. It's it is God's will that you should be holy. You must abstain from sexual immorality. But don't kind of respond as each of you must know how to control his own body in the holiness and honor. And what's your mood in you now? Yet to me, Chime, I will cook you. Say a share of Muslim. Every sexual, every, and you big fan said, the moment I'm not worried, when you are not married and you started having intercourse together, it's a sin. And no thing I'm already catching your answer. Yes, share also. Sometimes it's flesh, it's not easy. But make it a point to be easy for you. Because remember how long you've been waiting upon the Lord. And how many months left for you to have the ring on your finger. anger. So why can't we wait? We must know how to control our body. Our kukunyemu, any animonyamu. It's a glory when a woman is able to stay and control herself until the day of the ring. It's a glory when a man is able to stay, control himself until the day of I do. Now, I'm a woman, I'm a woman, I'm a woman, I'm a woman. Na etimi etimi. Na shewo no Christo di ku kwane munyo. So the foundation must be built from the beginning. But if we break the roots, then there is no more foundation. It sounds like after who to tell the front. The one starting from beginning now, our friend starting our own answer now, if you couldn't train the child from the beginning now. Not from the dream of Resubia. If the child grows to a certain point, it becomes very difficult for you to train that child. It becomes very difficult for you to tap into that child. That's how a marriage is. That is how courting and dating is. But if you are able to value yourself, that you are a child of God, so nothing goes in and nothing comes out. The man will begin to respect you. Very dignity. The woman will begin to respect you. And that respect will continue. And it will remain in the marriage. Let's be aware of this situation. It is very, very important. Even sometimes we get pregnant while we were dating and courtship. Sometimes we get pregnant and then we hide it. When the man of God asked, we said, no, we have never even slept. But we said, Omusha, I do now. Within a few months, a few weeks, not a full life, Pietchon. But time on soon, cry now, Kakakra. That's another goofy. The son said, yes, yes, when you're near some months in here. Let us do the will of God. Let us do the will of God. That's why we can climb verse 5 here. 1 Thessalonians 4, 3 to 5. You know? So we can climb verse 5. I say, not in a lustful passion. Not in a lustful passion. And yet, like the Gentiles, who do not know God. So we are supposed to know one day. Oh, we are because as a Christian, we should always try to remain what? Faithful and purity. It is very, very important. The lustful passion. Oh, this gentleman will kill me. Oh, my God. Oh, Charlie. Come and see a guy that I just saw. I can't even close my eyes. I'm just looking at him, and he also started staring at me. Oh, my God. I'm just falling in love already. It's a lust. It's a lust. One don't know what come on my ear that. It's a sin. It's a sin. It's woman shining soon. And must do the will of God. I said, not in a natural passion like the Gentiles who do not know God. Now, why would you need to be here? Why would you not be ready? Why can't we listen what the word of God is telling us? Why can't we listen to the voice that he is telling us? Nonsense. We have already fallen in love already in our heart. So it's going to be difficult for us to hear the voice of the Holy Spirit. It's going to be a problem for us to hear the voice of the Holy Spirit. Why? Because we have already fallen in it already. Once you fall in it, that's it. That's it. Now we're changing our name so. See them away. Oh my God, I can't wait. See. Only in Nayo. And so I can't own another. And that's a wound in our canoe. It's not only having a sex with a man, but it's the way you think. And the way your body will talk to you about that man. That also is the biggest challenge that this day is going on. The flesh of the body. And that our hormones begin to rise up. And you only need that crown and cover so much more. Because they are dangerous for us. When I'm one of our ass, not a bow say, that is the last.
Mama, I hope we'll be able to move here. I asked her, Dano, Cassa, and Mama. Call home.
So the moment that you feel that way, then you have to run to a man of God to deliver you. Because you saw the woman and your eyes couldn't come off. And you started opening your mouth. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. And you started panicking. You will see that the flesh is started. The lust is started. By the time you realize you are totally wet. That means you have allowed the spirit of demonic sexual, you have allowed that immorality into your life right now. So as a child of God, we must be careful. We must be very careful. That is why the word of God continues to tell us, pray without ceasing. Every minute we are praying. Every second we are praying. Do you think that lust can enter you? No. So since you have waited so patiently for all this year, we shouldn't allow ourselves for the lust to enter us because it's a spirit. The spirit of lust, the spirit of passion, oh my God, it can kill us. Especially when that guy disappoints you. Especially when that woman that you are dating, you are courting, disappoints you. That is the reason why a lot of kids, a lot of people committing suicide. That is because we are putting God aside and we are doing whatever we want. And the word of God is telling us. We must control ourselves. We must control ourselves. It is very important. Thank you.
Amen. Wonderful. Reverend Evangelist Betty Timothy Panther is our presenter of Marriage Survivor, and today's topic is, what does the Bible say about Christian dating and courtship? A lot of it. So you can chip in or come in with your question by dialing +1 712 770 4700. Dial access code is for 4700 4413699. That is access code. God richly bless you. Or you can text on WhatsApp. Text WhatsApp to +1 347 559 9329. Christian dating. How to caution. I have one sister on the line from Connecticut. If you have anything you want to say, you are welcome. Hello, Connecticut, are you ready? Okay, Connecticut is not ready. Hello, are you ready?
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, go ahead.
Fly all the way to a different country somewhere in Europe to see the person. Oh, when you find out for 3 days, I'm by you see who you find for two. No, come on in the end, I'm not here. Cra, and tell me because I say, Christopher, you do that. Yeah, it may recommend you be my obi, and I say, either a family friend, your own family member, or your brother or sister.
God bless you. Let me just quickly explain it so that evangelist will continue. Our sister is asking the question, is it okay to recommend a sister or a brother when it comes to marriage? Because she recommended or referred somebody to one of her friends, and apparently the person was out of country, so it happened that this guy traveled all the way to see the lady where she is, and he spent 3 days there. Actually, he has seen a very beautiful picture of the woman he wants to marry, but unfortunately, when he got to the place to see the woman, it wasn't the picture he saw. So that discouraged him so much that when he came back or when he returned, he decided not to continue with the relationship that he has started with the lady online or on the phone or with a picture or image. So is it okay to recommend someone to another person, recommend a woman to a man or a man to a woman in order to get married, prepare them for marriage? Reverend, that is the question for you.
Yes, it is okay to recommend. But as I'm saying, if you're a child of God, what you have to do is immediately the person talk about, There is nothing wrong. Most of the time, it always goes through somebody. Because not everybody that can go straight and say, it's always, most of the time, it goes through somebody. But what we have to do is, you shouldn't, step in first. You have to pray over that person. Whether you know that person, you have to say, so you fear the voice of God. The moment you remain faithful, whenever we remain faithful, if we fast now, definitely, you hear the Holy Spirit's voice. So we must always pray very seriously. But it shouldn't be said at once now, what's my heart lane? May God. No! No! That is wrong. That is wrong. We have to pray over it for God to give us a direction. And then if the man of God is in the house, you can tell the man of God, I have seen this person. Oh, so-and-so this person have introduced this man for me. As a man of God, he will definitely pray with you. He will definitely remember you, intercede with you on behalf of that issue. And definitely, an answer is going to come. Before and stand wired, we'll move you to the next step. But lust and passion, it is an American one song. Only a branch and static within 3 days, you fly to different countries. Ah, we call a question. Definitely, we call Prana. Definitely, only the better. But where are you going to stay? You don't belong to that place. He or she lives there. So you are going to visit him or her. What is going to happen? You end up sleeping with him or her, whether you love her, whether he is short, whether she is tall. Now, when you're not there, you know, I say, no, who make you her? I say, no, I see when you say it. That is the reason why. And so there is nothing wrong, but that person was supposed to pray very seriously. And we have to say, Prano, And to say, Christopher, you shouldn't, you know, move forward right away after somebody introduced a man or a woman to us. The moment you step forward, you know, is the lust and passion that is going to lead you. But me feel something for Kenya and Robo Humpaya. Kanka kraka 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 kraka. Omo kasa wa fun so no. Na onyame direct, onyame direct. Sometimes at the end, enye kurana, since you are praying to God, you know, God changed the situation. Emma, when you cry to me by Jason, Emma, you are dancing. But when we rush, even if the thing is good, Kurana, sometimes it turns into what? Bitterness. Now, I am in your name. I say, you don't even want to see his face anymore. You don't want to see her face anymore. Because it's not every house that we can go. It's not every family that we can enter to say, I do. No, it's not. So we must wait for God's direction before we can move a step. Thank you. God bless you.
Hello. God richly bless you for joining Hope of Glory Network. TV on Facebook, Hope of Glory Network Radio. Your DJ here is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Frank Ansah. My presenter is Reverend Evangelist Zafi Chimesi Prempe. And we thank you for your contributions and comments. Our sister is still there. Sister, are you still okay, or you want to come again with another question or contribution?
Yeah.
Because I have foreigners on the line, so I don't want to lose them. God richly bless you. Our sister just said actually it happened in front of her. She knows the details of the story, and apparently the guy is looking for somebody thicker than the lady she was talking to. And you know, some people like slim, some people like big women, or whatever you want to put it. But unfortunately, this lady was very slim woman, and she's a very good Christian actually. And this guy thought that once he had traveled all the way from where he is to Europe to see the lady, you could have slept with her, but unfortunately she didn't give a chance to sleep with her. That is what happened. And this has frustrated this young woman so much that at the end of the day, because of frustration, she has to go for anybody, anyhow, anywhere. So somebody just came and he just gave in for the person, and as a result, she ended up getting pregnancy without the man even accepting the responsibility. And now the guy that she gave birth with, the child, has even left her for another woman. So sad. So she's advising every one of us that when it comes to marriage, it doesn't matter how old you are, please just be patient. The right time. God has ordained time for everything. Your time will come. God richly bless you. Let's give it back to Reverend to continue. Reverend, back to you.
It's so sad sometimes. But you know what? Women, you're a good thing. Women are very quality. Women are very what? Valuable. Interesting, your question will be when we meet somebody, the man supposed to come and propose. The man supposed to come and propose. Why? Because when you're a boy, you're a strong man, you're a and she can a chest of your strong. And some Kadia do not, but I couldn't hear you. And she, because you have introduced the man. But she wants to fly and go. Earn money and go. If that man is not a child of God, the next thing she's gonna think is what? Sheep. Sorry for my way. But if he's a Christian, a real believer, he will not think otherwise. But the problem is, it is not good for us to go forth. But we must remain wherever we are and pray. It does not matter how old you are. It does not matter where you have reached. It doesn't matter if your friends or your siblings are all married. You have to wait. You have to wait. It is very important. Because of what has happened, when she came, she was supposed to advise herself to remain focused on the Lord and say, Lord, I look unto you. I'm waiting for you. But you see how the devil went. The devil will frustrate you. Continue frustrating you until you drop. That is where when your prayer starts up, when you can't even pray anymore. When you stop praying, this is how it is. The devil will try and take advantage of you and use you and later dump you. This is how it goes. When we read the 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 6, I say, and no one should ever exploit or take advantage of his brother in this regard. Because the Lord will avenge all such acts, as we have already told you, and Solomon warned you. But someone will be there and take advantage when it comes to that situation. You're taking advantage because lust, a well row of animal. The fool put in there and then. Because when she saw you now, oh my God, she couldn't do anything. But instead of you to remain faithful and tell the woman that no, it's okay, it's not appropriate. We are Christian, you know. That's what the work would say. In that case, you have taken advantage. You have taken advantage. And now, another person also has taken advantage of her. But it's an act of sin. And God is going to deal with such a person. She said to one another, but encourage you. It's not too late. God will provide for him. God will provide for her. But it's a Kofiako warrior. You mark it on the wall. God is going to deal with that man. Yes. Because the child is innocent. Not a media corner ever. Not a winning meter. And maybe you have to dump me. Or you shouldn't accept the child. My young from Swadia. But about Friday here, or you're innocent. But this is what is happening these days. That is the reason why we are telling everybody the preacher you must wait. Patient. Patient is the key. Our breakthrough. Patient is the success. Patient is the success. Stop remaining free. Let me sa kunkun ye mu na wa so obi biya ra or reject take sa instructions when na enye mi na wa reject na na mo ma reject on what for ratin any message go kunkun na so learn be careful and remain faithful. It's so deeply sad when you see a woman going through. It's very sad. Jesus loves you. And he cares about you. So whatever that you are in, whether you build the foundation or you didn't build the foundation, God still loves you. So come back to Jesus. Come back to him. He's ready to accept you. When you move, or you are in here, then you are in here. When you come to him and say, Lord Jesus, I have sinned against you. Father, please forgive me. I have sinned under you, but I have refused to listen to your word. So I have sinned against you out of lust and passion has led me to destruction. So Lord, have mercy on me. Have compassion on me. I promise you, he will have compassion on you. And he will accept you. So whatever the situation is, Jesus is calling you. Nothing is too late. Nothing is impossible. In him, there is life. In him, there is love. In him, there is peace. In him, there is prosperity. So don't worry. Don't worry. He loves you. And forever, he loves you. Only when you avail yourself and ask for forgiveness, he will surely forgive you. He will surely forgive you. Onyami enshla ubebre. Ena yedi ya sama akwevi. Onshla na wanya wakasi. Oma uni wabushi enyina kufat. Na onka uhu na wantina ni munchla. Afumchobi ya. A abedi ya ra. The vampire will preach about them. Stop on your mouth, Alfonso. Now, one thing I didn't show. Now, all money, all my wound will be today. I need any money. The ancient Trinity will go crying anymore. Whatever that has happened, remember.